Hi everyone, this is Georgina. I'm going to do a Draw My Life video for Ruth Bader Ginsburg. I chose her because I think she is a very fascinating woman. So let's get started. It all started on March 15th, 1933, when Ruth was born in Brooklyn, New York, from two loving parents, Celia and Nathan Bader. She had an older sister who died of meningitis when Ruth was a baby. Ruth was originally born Joan Ruth Bader, but her mom realized too many people were named Joan, so she started calling Ruth by her middle name. Ruth's dad worked at a clothing shop, then moved to owning a fur shop. Her mother did not work because at that point in time, women were excluded from working out of the house, so she stayed at home. It was decided Ruth would not be at school the day of her high school graduation. The reason for that was because Ruth's mother had died of cancer the very same day. When Ruth recovered from her mother's death, she decided to go to Cornell University, the same college her mother may have gone to had she been encouraged. In 1950, very few girls went to college, but amazingly, Ruth won a New York State scholarship. At Cornell, male students outnumbered female students 4-1. When she got to Cornell, she wanted no one to think she was smart, so she studied in the girls' bathroom. She did meet someone who liked that she was smart. His name was Martin Ginsburg. With her diploma in hand, Ruth graduated top of her class from Cornell University in 1954. A month after she graduated from Cornell, she decided to marry Martin and became Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Right after they got married, Ruth and Martin had a baby. They named the baby Jane. After Jane was born, she thought she would make a great lawyer, so she decided to go to Harvard Law School to study law. Although her mother was supportive and encouraged her daughter's education, her father believed that a woman's place was in the home, and she should stay at home with her daughter and not go to school. Even still, Ruth persisted. While at Harvard, Ruth's husband went ill, and Ruth had to take care of him while he was ill, help him with his schoolwork, do her own work, and she did all of that while also taking care of their daughter, Jane. Ruth's husband graduated from Harvard soon after and got a job in New York, so Ruth transferred to Columbia Law School. About 1 year later, she graduated from Columbia Law School and headed on to see which firm would hire her. Every time she tried to get a job, she would hear something like this. Are you a woman? It looks like you're a mother. And you say you're Jewish? No way. We won't hire you. Get out of here. Until, sure, you could be a professor here, said Rutgers Law School. After she got hired, she decided to co-found the Women's Rights Project at the ACLU. Then she got nominated by President Jimmy Carter to serve in the U.S. Court of Appeals. She served there for 13 years, and then she got a call from President Bill Clinton to serve in the U.S. Supreme Court Justice. She had a speech that was where she accepted the job. In that speech, she spoke of her late mother. She said, "I pray that I may be all that she may have been, had she lived in an age when women could aspire and achieve, and daughters were cherished as much as sons." As amazing as it already is, there is more. In 2009, Ruth found out that she had cancer and needed surgery. Only 2 weeks after her surgery, she decided that she would still return to the court because she wanted everyone to see there should be at least one woman on the court no matter what state they're in. She battled sexism in her own life and career. Some of her accomplishments include becoming the second female law professor at Rutgers, and she fought for equal pay there, co-founding the first law journal or law book on women's rights. Now Supreme Court Justice, and she's a role model for what every little girl like me is capable of achieving. Thank you for watching. Bye!